The views and opinions of this broadcast do not reflect the views and opinions of Armed Media, UNU Productions and its affiliates. Enjoy the show.
I'm a big fish in a small pond. Got my days free and the nights long. I create my own reality. Who I am is fine with me. As famous as I want to be. Who I am is fine with me. To who I am.
Okay, here we go. 3, 2, 1, blast off.
Oh, yeah.
Hi, everybody. It's Maria from What's the Story with Maria. How's it going?
Oh, this way.
Welcome to our little studio in the Heights, Washington Heights in New York City. We want to welcome you to What's the Story with Maria. We meet here every week.
Yes.
Every Tuesday, 9 p.m. Eastern. And we want to welcome you. So far, Chris DePiro has come in.
Of
Richard
course.
Koch has come in. Jacqueline Marie. Hi, Dr. Jackie. John Fitzgerald has joined us. Hi, guys. How are you? So we are coming live. We have all kinds of hearts coming up. Eddie Kutu from Blade Salon in Rocky Hill, Connecticut. Wow. David Slauson. Hi, honey. He's a regular. Darius Frowner. Hi,
hey,
Darius.
Big show tomorrow.
Yep, we got big shows tomorrow, Darius and I. Darius was... he's doing all kinds of auditions today. Oh my God, he's so busy.
Oh, he must be exhausted.
He is exhausted, but he keeps going. He keeps it going. Erica Kraut, DeMarch is there, and John Pandish. Funny enough, Erica is calling in a little while. We're very excited.
It's going to be great.
A lot of what we're doing tonight is centers around a project that Erica and Lynn worked on, and we really want to tell the world about it. Richard Koch says, back from Japan.
Whoa.
Richard, wow.
Konnichiwa.
What does that mean?
Hello.
Oh, it means hello. Konnichiwa to you, Richard. Richard is Dutch, but his family's from Argentina, and he's been all over the world. Okay, so let me see. George Hernandez has joined us. Ed Kutu says, hello from Connecticut. That's right.
Hi.
If you want to get your hair did, go see Eddie in Rocky Hill, Connecticut. Mark Katzoff, he's from Boston. We were just talking about Boston a little while ago.
Oh,
Chris
yeah.
DePiro says, download the Amuse app. Damn right, download the
Amuse
app.
Hi, Chris. So, we were just playing Gabon Produce music.
A little while ago.
It was rocking in this house.
It really was rocking in this house. Now, we want to let you know that if you want to find our show, of course, you can find us on Facebook Live. We always Facebook Live the episodes. But what am I doing here? I am going through Armed Radio, our wonderful producer and engineer, Jim Bell. We want to thank him. He's in New Hampshire running all the...
Thank you, Jim.
He's like the mad scientist in there, running all these... I picture you as a mad scientist, Jimmy, with all these levers and all kinds of things running the show. So please come back and see us. Now, if you miss it, I do save the video, which is wonderful. But also, you can find us in podcast at iHeartRadio, Spreaker, and Spotify. You type in What's the Story with Maria, and our shows will come up. And then, of course, Leo Rodriguez puts it into an iTunes. He puts it up on
iTunes.
He's
on the road, isn't he?
He is on the road. He's driving to Portland, Oregon.
On the road
he's
again.
Be working. Suzanne Mason has joined us. So, Herman Valles. Okay, so we want to get right to it and let you folks know what tonight is all about. Every show has a theme, as you know. Tonight we're calling the show Balancing Act. Jeannie Craigie from my hometown of Stoneham, she's a town moderator. Hi, Jeannie, has joined us. She comes on every week.
Oh, Jeannie, you're going to love her upcoming song, her voiceover. Wait till you hear her.
We're doing
Boston.
Some voiceovers tonight.
She's doing some Boston for you.
Some animation. We're doing all kinds of stuff. Now, Erica, who's going to call in about 3 minutes, is Lynn's cousin.
Actually, yeah. My mom and Erica's grandma were cousins. So she's like my second cousin, whatever that comes out to. Doesn't matter. We are family.
And Erica, she'll tell you all about what she does. And also, Joe Brennan.
Joe!
Oh, no, not yet. Joe Roman Lars, I couldn't read. But Joe
Hi,
Brennan.
Joe.
So Erica is calling in because she'll tell you what she does, but she wrote an amazing book, a children's book, and it has to do with balance. But
that's how Maria knows Erica.
That's
from
how
the
I
book.
And you
but
know
I knew
her from
Erica
family.
Had first invented this amazing. Well, first of all, she's brilliant. I'm just telling you, not like me. She's really
not like you. You're a genius.
No, she's like genius runs a genius. She's a genius. And she's a physical therapist, and she used to work at the Kessler Institute in Jersey years ago. She lives in Denver. She's going to tell you all about how.
Yeah, she'll call in and let you know.
This thing that I'm holding, I had to bring it to show Maria. She invented this. Get a look at this. You guys are not. It looks like a yoga mat, right? And it's got, you see this? It's got like, oh, how do this one?
Numbers.
It's backwards. Balance matters. And these feet, these little paws, they come and they sit right on here. See the feet? I can't step on it because the camera won't see it. And I step on it, and it clicks, and I have one pair, two pairs. She's probably laughing. Erica, don't laugh at me. But I wasn't going to let this go
right, so
without
this
you
is,
seeing. This is the mat, and it's a yoga mat. And we're going to talk about buying this. I think every single physical therapist should have this because it's going to change your life. Because balance is really what we need to talk about today.
Yeah, and we all use it. That's something we all use. We want to... Rena Quignali-Berge, my cousin, since we're showing off cousins, from Boston, has just checked in. Hello. She says, hello, ladies. Hello.
Hi, honey.
Rena. And Hector Garcia from Miami has checked in, our Cuban friend. Frank Zahn, John Bronson's husband.
Oh, Frank Zahn.
Hi, Frank. He was here this weekend for the...
I missed the party. I know. I'm sorry. I'm late for the party.
Listen, but not too late because you're here now. All right, so we're going to focus tonight. We're going to, really, our show is dedicated
so
to...
So this story, so we start with the how do you balance.
Well, Erica's going to call in and tell us about what she does. And
this little book is what we're talking about. This children's book. It's not just adults that have balance issues. Even though she works with many Parkinson's, there you go, patients who have issues with balance, or people like me, which is getting old, who are likely to fall.
Oh, the phone is ringing.
And there's Erica. Do, 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 do.
Okay. Hi, Erica. Can you hear me?
I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can. And keep your voice at that volume. It's perfect. So, everybody, this is Erica DeMarch. How are you, Erica?
Hi, honey. I'm good. And I was laughing, Lynn, of you showing the map.
I said, she's going to kill me showing the map, but I had to show it.
So, Erica, let's just start by telling everybody what your title is. How do we know what you do?
So, I'm a physical therapist, and I'm the founder and CEO of Step and Connect.
Step and Connect, which I hashtagged. And what came first, the mat or the book?
The mat came first.
The mat came first. And so this book, which we're going to hold up, Erica, so we showed the mat, which we'll show later on as well. But this book, which Erica... it was her brainchild, wrote this beautiful for children. Now, so we're going to talk more about the book as the night goes on. But Erica, now you have two young daughters, right?
Yes, they are the stars of the book, Ella and Sienna.
Okay,
Ella and Sienna.
Now, was it was it questions they were asking you about balance, or did you find working with children that you wanted a better way to explain it? Tell us how the book came to be.
Well, they definitely inspired me to write the book. They asked different questions on balance, and they were having fun using the mat.
Okay.
So they would be doing different exercises and jumping on it, and so I decided that let's write a book and explain balance. But it's also for... We're developing an intergenerational program so adults and kids can learn a fun way about balance, but then also practice it together.
Yeah, it's
beautiful.
Really all ages.
And all ages, absolutely. And also, we have a lot of dancers that watch the show. There's a lot of people. But my dad and I were just talking. He's 84. He's going to be 84 this month, and he's going to physical therapy now to work on his balance. Yes. And it's so funny that Lynn brought over this mat because I thought this is exactly
what he needs.
What he needs. Yeah.
And you roll it right up. It's like a no-brainer.
I know. You brought it in. I couldn't believe it. And now the animals in the book, because we're going to go through it later on. Lynn and I are going to talk about the
voice. Maria did the voices of this recording of this book. She made each of these animals come to life.
Now, so I wanted to ask you, because I know your kids are big fans of the animals. Did you come up with the animals, or did your kids, or how did that come to be? Or Lynn?
No, not me.
No, that was definitely my children, Ellen, Sienna.
Wow.
So,
Ella.
They they helped me research the different animals that we wanted to do for balance. So there were certain concepts I wanted in the book, but okay. then we booked how we can add those animals for it.
And how old are they? How old are your kids?
Ella?
5 and 7.
Oh, my God. What smart kids.
Faces. Oh, my God. I wish I had a picture here. I'd show you.
One of these days, yeah. we'll get to meet them. So, okay, so you wanted to explain balance through animals, and so you did the research with your kids.
Yes, and they also even helped from the whole concept of, you know, editing, finding little things that they wanted in and out of the book, the pictures.
That's perfect. You have a focus group that lives under your roof.
Exactly.
I mean, people pay big money for focus groups, and who okay. needs it? You have a perfect focus group there. And what the book is good for what ages, Erica?
So, depending on reading, but around 2 to 10, probably, I would
perfect.
Say. Because the concepts the 10-year-olds will get, but the 2-year-olds can still just have fun doing the different activities.
Absolutely. And this could also be used, because I also teach, so when I see things like this, I mean, I always get a light bulb. This could really be used in classes as well. Like, I've already shared it with one of the dance specialists that I teach at the Mayo Performing Arts Center.
Oh, that's great for that.
Yep, in
great.
Morristown. I already shared it with one of the teachers, and she loved it.
Oh, thank you so much. And that's definitely, you know, a different way to talk about your sense of touch if you're not using your eyes and how you can incorporate the different balance systems.
Okay, wonderful.
And I have a question, Erica. Out of all the animals Maria did, because it's coming and we're waiting.
I can't wait.
What was their favorite of all the animals of the voiceovers?
Your
Maria's?
Little girls.
My girls.
Yeah.
What was I wish they were here with me right now and they could tell you themselves. But I think they like the cat.
The cat.
I think the cheetah was definitely a
cheetah,
favorite.
The cheetah. So Ella and
the mountain goat. I think the mountain goat, like when you were going up the mountain, it's at those voices they were laughing at.
Oh,
down.
Right. Yeah,
down.
I'm
yes,
telling you,
exactly.
if you can get a kid to laugh, you're doing something right.
That's right.
and Maria, my Boston friends, actually said it sounded like, the seal actually sounded like one of his brothers.
Wow! I believe that.
Wicked smart.
Wicked smart. You know why? Because my family's from Boston, Eric. I don't know if you knew that.
I did know that, yeah. And he laughed and he's like, it sounds like you.
Oh, my God. So I channeled my Uncle Nicky, actually, for that one.
Oh, wait till they hear that.
Yeah. So that makes me happy that the Boston people like that. That's
all
fantastic. Right. So now... go ahead.
You definitely made the animals come to life. So you actually did the voiceovers before the illustrations.
Oh, really?
It actually helped the illustrator. She listened to the song a lot to help see what the animals would look like, which really helped.
Oh, wonderful. And let's give the illustrator a shout-out. Her name is what, Erica?
Yep. Elizabeth Hickson.
Okay. And how did you find her?
So she actually is a nanny for one of my daughter's friends.
Oh, my God.
Did
an extremely great job. Really actually able to get the animals, but also the kids' movements were really important because she was great at doing some of the movements of youth.
So did she watch the kids' movements and then from there and listen to the song? This is what it's sounding like so far. And then that's where the illustrations were born out of, right?
Exactly.
I told you. I thought
that's what Lynn said.
I think so. Maria's voices helped her draw the
that's
faces.
Great.
I told you. It really was.
That makes me so happy.
Wait till you guys hear her do this.
Well, I got to tell you, I was so happy to work on this project. First of all, I'll do anything with Lynn. I would follow Lynn anywhere she goes.
We laughed the whole time in the studio. We laughed more than we worked.
We got it done in really
quick. We got it done fast.
Like in a day, I think we got it done. In 2 days?
Because you're wicked smart.
Yeah, I'm wicked smart like that. but, okay, so now what, Erica, if people want to find this book, how do they find it?
So they can go on our website at stepconnect.com.
It's on the, we tagged it here.
We hashtagged it, but I'm going to also put it on there, stepconnect.com, okay?
And then we also do, so then we sell that ourselves, so we have the soft or hardcover on our website, and then we also do sell it through Amazon.
Okay, and also the audio, if they want to buy the audio is only $1. It goes,
And that's on
Go ahead.
And that's on Amazon. Yep, and is it on iTunes too, I think, now, right?
It should be, yeah, it should be there by now. I'm reading. Yeah. Hold on. Joseph Brennan. All right.
Joe Brennan has checked
yes,
in.
Yes, it's on iTunes. Is it on iTunes, Joe?
Yeah, we don't want to keep Erica too long because we know, you know, you have kids and stuff, but we wanted to get the information out. And as a physical therapist, I mean, you've been doing this kind of work a long time, right?
Yeah, almost 18 years.
18 years, wow. So you know your stuff, and you know
she
that...
She lives in Denver.
Denver. So...
Colorado.
Are you still a gun for hire as a physical therapist, or have you moved on to just books now and mats?
No, I still see clients. I see clients here in Denver, and now I'm teaching more courses for healthcare professionals on understanding balance.
Unbelievable. Oh, well,
balance matters.
Balance does matter.
This balance
is
matters.
Erica DeMarc.
And we are not falling this winter in the snow or
no.
the ice.
Both of us fell last year. I can't believe.
Oh, I can't. No. It's like, this is horrible. No one's falling. We're working on our core, right,
that's
Erica?
Right. Core
we're
issues.
Working on the
yeah.
mat, and I'm learning how to balance. And if I have to fall, I'm going down
the
right way.
We're going to learn how to fall gracefully.
No, you're not going
to
fall. You're going to keep working on balance.
That's
and
right.
And Darren actually just said, I saw that they're loving the show, that Sienna and Ella are watching it.
Yeah, well, we're going to do the animals for them next. So we're going to let you go and tell you thank you so much for calling
okay,
in.
Okay, Erica, keep listening because we're doing your song.
Now, also,
right,
Erica,
if
there's anything that you want to type in while you're watching it to help people find you quicker, please do. Any information, please, because people watch the video and do read those comments. And when we save the video, those comments are archived. Okay.
All right. Yeah, and if anybody has questions on just the mat, feel free to reach out to
yes.
me. Yes, you know.
Please, pick it up for your parent who's
I'm going to get it for my
your
dad.
Grandparent you have.
I'm
or yourself.
Yep.
I have one.
Yeah, that thing, that's amazing.
And the price is
and it,
right.
And it folds up. It really, it's small. I love it. I can't wait to get one for my dad. So thank you so much for putting in all this work and helping people stay on their feet. And
yeah.
this, I love this book. I just love it. I can't wait to tell my friends about it.
And thank you so much for being part of this, you guys. You've made this the reality of
this is going to be great.
Well, thank you, sweetheart.
Oh,
have a wonderful
right.
night. And
thank you.
Tell the girls,
Ella
and Sienna, we said hello.
All right, they're listening. So.
Oh, great. Okay, we're going to do it now.
Okay.
All right,
yes.
Good night.
All right, love your
list.
Thanks.
I love you, Erica, my cousin.
All right, so we're going to...
So I'm going to tell you first.
Yeah, you explain.
So she gave me like, she wrote me like a kind of a poem, an idea for the song. And I said, this is all great. If you trust me, I'm going to go with it. I'm going to write a song for all these animals.
So she just wrote a
poem. So these two girls go to the zoo. And here we go. No, okay. The first thing, they're at the gym.
Her daughters, okay? Right?
Yes. At gymnastics, there's a balance beam. Not as easy as it seems. Ella didn't want to fall. Ella, Sienna was afraid to try. It was scary, way too high. Some confidence they needed, that's all. Now they see a cat. Then they're going, walking, they see a cat, right?
Right.
A cat was walking high and free. Along a fence without a care. Here we go. Straight without a problem. His feet not even wobbling. They said, Mr. Cat, how you walking way up there? And then I say, hey cat, how do you balance like that? Tell us just what we're looking at, Maria.
Balance, yeah, it's in our base. We use our feet while in one place. We stay wide and low. That's how we know we won't fall flat. That's how we balance like that.
Well, that's how
we have nine lives
like that. Wow, that's how we balance like that. So that's the first character is the cat. So they're walking and they see a cat on the fence walking, you know.
Well, you
and
know how cats can walk.
They can walk like, well, what? And it's so cool. So anyway, Maria does this cat voice and she's decided that the cat's a cool cat.
Well, a cool cat, it could be like a jazz musician. That's
yes,
exactly.
This is it. This cat's a jazz musician. So she's telling me all about this cat. So then she would riff in the language that this animal
of the cat.
Was, of the cat. So now the next one's an owl. So Maria, let's talk about this owl. So who did you think of?
We don't need to do this. You don't want to do this part, right?
We can skip that now.
Yeah, okay,
the
good.
Owl. So now we're going to go to the owl. And
so Linny, before every animal, said, she would give me a little information on the animal, and then she said, you know, you create a voice. I won't tell you what to do. But, like, I really feel like as an actor or a voiceover, either way, you have to choose, like what I usually do is I choose someone in my brain that I'm imitating.
Yes.
And, you know, like that I have to pick a real person. I can't just, you know, so this, the owl was an homage to my friend Elliot. And Elliot is this very sweet, sweet little kind of guy that he's older and he's just like very friendly and very unassuming and he's from New York and he talks like this. So I said, oh my God, Elliot the owl.
Elliot, so Elliot, they go to the zoo. Okay, so let me go back to this, the zoo. So they're going to the zoo and they see this owl. So together they went strolling, met an owl wise and knowing. Moving in darkest night. Okay, Mr. Owl, just how do you fly and see when you can't move your eyes like me, but still, what is it? You have the greatest sense of sight. Mr. Owl, how do you balance like that? Tell us just what we're looking at.
Well, you know I've got the biggest eyes. My head moves left and right, but guys, my neck's so flexible. My head can rotate almost all the way around.
Ow.
It's okay, it's steak, but I can't chit-chat. That's how I balance like that.
Wow, that's how you balance like that. Wow, and then you would give some instructions. What did the owl say?
The owl would give instructions.
Keep your head still. Look to the right now and look to the left. What do you see? It's an owl talking. I can't do that. I need to move my head. Try turning your head and look to the right. Now look to the left. That's it. Maybe you don't include. I mean, do what you gotta do.
I don't know. Do what you feel like doing. Go crazy.
That's what Elliot would say, right?
Okay, so that was the owl. Is this so much fun? Now you know why we were laughing hysterical. Oh my gosh. Wait, get ready. Because the kids are watching. I got to watch what I say.
Hi, Ella. Hi, Sienna.
This was my favorite. So we're going to do the elephants. And what made you choose this? I am interviewing Maria tonight. Maria, what made you choose this voice for the elephant?
Well, first of all, I will thank you. Lynn never told me what to do with it. She did tell me rhythms and how she wanted to hear it. But she said, you choose. So I was, the next one is an elephant. So I looked up, at there. Did you know that there are two different kinds of elephants? I did not. One is an African elephant, one is an Indian elephant. So I said, wouldn't it be great, I chose the Indian elephant, and I thought, wouldn't it be great if I could do that elephant as an Indian man? You know, like it would be so fun, like wise elephant,
yes.
An older Indian gentleman. So.
Okay.
I decided to go with, so go ahead, you go.
We're changing the key, all right, because otherwise I'm boring everybody. Moving one another venture, da 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 da. I'll just start, Mr. Elephant. Mr. Elephant, how do you balance like that? Tell us just what we're looking at.
I don't have the greatest sight. My foot placement's left and right. Big steps, don't make much sound. My trunk helps feel the ground. So I don't fall flat. That would be pretty loud. That's how I balance
That's how you balance like that. Let's see what you wrote there with him.
Okay, so the wise Indian elephant said, now stomp, stomp, stomp your feet like me. But can you move slowly and softly? Lift your feet as high as you can and step. Long right foot, then left foot, right and left. Now repeat, eyes closed. Since I can't see, well, you may need to use your hands. I use my trunk.
I'm on the other side of the glass of the studio on the floor. And the poor engineer, he didn't know if I was crying or whatever.
He was very calm. Engineers are always calm.
But he's very dry. Terry, we love Terry from Brizzy. We got to give him a little shout out, Terry. He puts up with me. He did the whole Amuse app, so he knows me very well. All right. Oh, so now we're moving on. Maria, I'm interviewing you. Maria, what? The mountain goat is our next animal.
Oh, it is? Or is it the cheetah?
Sorry. The cheetah is our next
animal. Okay, I'm paying attention to class today.
So no, she's very good today. So, what made you choose this voice? And this is Ella and Sienna's favorite animal.
The cheetah. All right, so the cheetah for me was a younger person. Was definitely like the elephant was an older, wiser Indian man. But, well, I thought to myself, she's a cheetah. She's wearing a beautiful coat, rather expensive, I might add. She's fast. She's slim. She's a little self-centered.
Okay.
Cheetahs can be self-centered. Really fast-paced. No attention span. I see it. I want it. And I thought, who does that remind me of? Really young, kind of, entitled women. So we gave the cheetah. She's like really fast. She can't be bothered with anything. So that kind of girl, to me, was the cheetah.
All right. Well, we'll skip the first verse.
Okay, so...
All right, we're going to start with good balance. Good balance. So she says, good balance uses touch and sight. Yeah, here he is. They help you stay upright. So see, cheetah has a big surprise. Go ahead.
Yeah, I'm a winner here because I use my inner ear. It's called vestibular. Google it, guys.
1, 2, 3, 4. Hey, how do you balance like that? Sorry. Tell us just what we're looking at. And there you go.
I've got the longest tail for balance, the fastest speed. Well, that's my talent. I grip the ground with my claws. Yeah, I'm a cool cat. That's how I balance like that.
Yeah, that's how you balance like that. Yeah, that's how you
run as fast as a cheetah and try to stay in a straight line. You see how she's a little arrogant. Or pretend you're a gazelle running from the cheetah and run in a zigzag back and forth, back and forth. That's to me what the cheetah would sound
like. Oh, she's so annoying. She's just so annoying.
She is, but I mean, she might know what she's doing.
But you know, it's called vestibular. Google it, guys.
Right. It's called vestibular. Google it, guys.
Yeah, we like that one. All right. So, the mountain goat. Maria. Now we have a mountain goat. We're going to change the key because I'm going crazy.
Okay.
So, the mountain goat. Whose voice is this?
Well, when I thought of mountain goat, I automatically went to Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer and Yukon Cornelius. When I think of a mountain, like any kind of mountain climber, I think of Yukon Cornelius.
Oh, Yukon with the ice pick.
Yes.
Going through the mountain. Okay.
Remember from my childhood and all our childhood. So I thought I'm going to channel Yukon Cornelius. So
every time you hear Maria do the goat, she has this echo thing. I don't know what people are writing, but it's like.
Well, we'll go back and read what they're writing.
Down, down, down. You know,
down. Well, he falls. You know, he's always on a mountain from flying down. I mean. He's very busy.
All right, what key are we on? Let's stay in A. Okay, A. Up the hill, up the hill, they walked in tired feet. A voice came. Who'd they meet?
It's me, the mountain goat. What's up? And now, easily, all this climbing.
I do it all the time.
I do this all the time, and my feet, well, they're like suction cups.
Mr. Mountain Goat, how do you balance like that? Tell us just what we're looking at.
I have the hooves, they have the strongest grip. So on the incline, I don't slip. On a rocky mountainside, I go down, 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 down.
I know, I should. Splat!
That's how I balance like that.
That's how they balance. So the goat, every time... All in the studio. Didn't matter what we were doing. I'm going to take it again. Again!
We had to keep putting echoes.
Water. It was getting so bad. I didn't know. And Terry didn't know what to keep on the reel. I mean, I say reel. I'm dating myself.
Yeah, I know.
The studio.
Reel. Let's call it a reel.
On the
reel. People know what we mean.
What is it, 1979? Okay. Okay, is this the last one?
I think
it's
so.
It's the last one.
Seal, yeah.
You're going to miss this. Okay. This is the seal. So we made it a harbor seal. So, of course, this is where Boston comes in.
Well, so as soon as most people hear it as harbor, right? But if you live in Boston, Massachusetts, you hear it as harbor, the harbor seal. So we decided to make the harbor seal from New England, right?
Yes.
So we gave him a kind of a New England accent, and I just channeled my Uncle Nicky.
Uncle Nick, I don't know.
Uncle Nicky is amazing.
They know Uncle Nicky,
but they know. But it'll just sound like a Boston guy. So that's what we did with the harbor seal.
Yeah. Okay. Here we go. But change the key because I'm going crazy. In the water up ahead, they found a pinniped.
Over here, it's me, Mr. Seal, right here, guys.
He was balancing a ball with no work at all, and on his nose.
Oh, really, guys? Come on. It's no big deal.
Mr. Steele, how do you balance like that? Just tell us just what we're looking at.
I use my sense of touch. My whiskers help adjust the ball up and down, up and down. Keep it centered, even if it's all wet. Hey, that's how you balance like that.
Oh, that's how you balance like that. Steele, do we have one?
I don't think we do have
one. Okay, we don't have anything. So, when she did the Boston thing, actually, I have to say, I wanted her to do the Boston thing, but all I knew there was a seal. So I'm like a crazy lunatic finding a seal that would be good. But when I saw Harbor, I'm not like an animal professional. So I look up Harbor Seal and said, oh my gosh, this is the best one.
The Harbor Seal.
So...
yeah, and I pictured him with like a little hat.
So in the song,
maybe well, like a cup of chowder. You know, he was drinking like a cup of clam chowder on a cold day. The Harbor Seal.
So the last animal, of course, is the human animal, and then the voice of, I think, Yukon Cornelius is, you know, you forgot the human animal, owl, the owl.
You forgot the human animal.
Yeah,
right.
Do it again for the girls.
No, that's the owl.
Ella and Sienna, go ahead, say that again.
You forgot the human animal.
Right? And we do
it. You know, the girls have heard this song, Ella and Sienna. They've heard it, and the kids, they never see the face of the voice. So this is really special. There it is, right there.
But really, girls, it has nothing to do with the face. It has to do with your imagination.
That's right.
And my imagination.
And Rodan and Fields. Sorry.
Oh, well. Your imagination, my imagination, kids.
Yeah.
Out there. And think about doing voices yourself. Like, if you think about an object, an animal, anything, what voice would it have? That might be a good homework project for you, for kids, right?
Well, we're going to finish up because the very end, the
you love it.
The 11 o'clock, the human animal sings, you know, I'll sing a little bit. You want to balance, make a wide... let's be flat. So you want to balance, make a wide base. Like if you want to balance yourself, get low and bend your knees, clear the space, your eyes and ears and muscles, talk to your brain to find the points of balance again and again and again. And you say, and again.
And again, again, again.
And then we sing, wow, that's how you
balance like
cat, cat.
Oh, yeah, because I'm a cool cat. I've got 9 lines.
That's
a
good one.
Balance, man.
Now let's do the owl. What was the owl?
That's right, the owl. I have to think about it sometimes because I'm so tired. I sleep a lot.
Yeah. Oh, wait. Next one is elephant.
The elephant would just try balance slowly, and softly.
Softly, yes.
Softly and slowly together at the same time.
Cheetah.
Oh my god, I'm like the fastest of all of the animals. I don't even care. Like, I can't even see them. I ran so fast past them. I don't even know where they are, and I don't care.
Okay, and what have we missed? The cheetah.
The mountain goat would be just going down. There he goes now again and again.
Seal. Wow, that's heavy.
The Harbor Seal says, come on, everybody, let's have a cup of chowder. And then just try to balance. Don't eat too much, because you got to work on your core. On the North Shore. Of the harbor.
And that's how we balance like that.
That's it. That is our little presentation.
It's a 99 cents wonder. It's a 99 cents wonder download.
Let's show that book again. Here's the beauty of all this. So Erica DeMarsh has created this beautiful book. Her illustrator... Elizabeth Hickson, who is a nanny and a beautiful artist. And the beauty of this book is it shows you all the balance, the different moves that kids and adults, of course, can do, and Ella and Sienna. And then it shows, you know, them on the balance beam and running into the different animals. It's like a beautiful, beautiful book. And there's the elephant. There's the elephant right now. So there's the cheetah. Right, So it's just an amazing, amazing...
But Maria's voice was the inspiration for these pictures. There you go.
Oh, well, that makes me happy. Yeah. But it's just a beautiful book, and I've been turning my friends onto it that have kids and also are teachers. But so you can get that on Amazon and also on Erica's website, which she posted, stepandconnect.com. Yeah. And also, this is what we want to tell you about. So if you want to hear our... It's really well done the way we did it in the studio. We were just fooling around now, but... You go on Amazon, and when you look at the book, underneath it, you can buy the song.
The actual, it's a download, 99 cents.
It's 99 cents for the download, and you can hear that, and then it goes on your Amazon Music.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's really fun, so we do all the animals. And so we wanted to share that with you tonight.
Yeah.
And we wanted to just let people know about Erica's book, and that Lynn wrote, now let's talk about your part in this, Lynn. So, yeah, so Erica how did this process
told me
happen?
She wanted to make a kid's book, and could I write possible music to go along with the book? And you could read what's going on, because I don't know what to write.
Yeah, I'm going to go back and read.
I said, she kind of let me fly with it. But the problem was it was so long. So it's, musicians understand, you have a track, one long song and one track, because each animal should be a different track. So I recorded every track separately. And then we were kind of figuring that it needed to be one long loop.
Yeah.
For kids. So when we were kids, we used to have cassette. You know, my kids were little. They had cassettes, and you could stop the cassette and turn it over. Or this. Now it's just, it doesn't have that. It's a track. One track leads to the next, leads to the next. So it is like one song.
Yeah, one download. Very long song. It's wonderful. So we are trying to say hi to some of our friends, but there's so many. So I'm going to try to scroll back, but... Paul Bruno has joined us. Hi, Paul.
We were just playing Gavon's music. We should play
Paul. Yeah, yeah. So go ahead. Play the Gavon's music.
Now, you talk while we do that.
All right. So, yeah, you underscore with Gavon's produce, which Chris DePiero is the filmmaker on that. Paul Bruno is the star of that. So, yeah, Lynn also scores movies and series and all kinds. That's what she does. So Debbie Greenberg has joined us. Jeannie Singliano Zvich has joined us. Kenny Holcomb. Hi, Kenny. How you doing, buddy? Aaron Willis has joined us. Leo Rodriguez. Leo. Oh, my God, Leo. Thank God you're here. I think he is in Portland now, right, Leo? Dot Hartnett has joined us, so you're playing the Gavon's theme song there. Dot Hartnett says, Dorothy Bradley from Somerville. Hi, Dorothy. How nice to see you on there. Leo, your voice has changed, he said. Robert Portis has joined us. I think that's your brother,
my
Robert.
Brother.
Robbie Nelson has joined us. Hi, Robbie Nelson. Anthony Fett, we love Anthony Fett. Step and Connect. Okay, great. So Step and Connect. Love how you give the animals each a personality.
See?
Both are amazing. Thank you, Erica. Yeah, but you have to, you know, when you do something like that, you have to give them personalities. That's what all the motivation comes from, right?
It's true.
Jessica Schaefer Jaffe has joined us, amazing singer. Forrest Hedden. Forrest, I want to talk to you very soon because Forrest just wrote a book.
Woo.
And I want to have Forrest on the show. So I was looking at that. Let's work it out, Forrest. Linda Ozino.
My cousin.
Oh, that's your
Linda,
cousin?
Erica's mom.
Oh, wonderful.
Hi, Linda.
Hi, Linda.
She's in Colorado.
Aaron Willis has joined us. Trisha Kilty, my friend from Stoneham, Massachusetts. Hi, Pat. How are you, honey? Paul Donnellan. Paul Donnellan lived in New York for a long time. Now he's out west, I believe. Brendan Ryan, Sergeant Brendan Ryan.
Oh, Sergeant.
We try to have him on. He plays the bagpipes.
Oh, that's
Stephen Collier has joined us. I think you know Stephen Collier.
Sure, I do.
Great singer. Lisa Marie. So many. Oh, my God. Janine Molinari.
Hi, Janine.
How are you? Janine, now, you talk about balance. Janine is has a dance school. Janine, if I were you, I would buy this book and look at it because
good for the little ones.
It's all about balance. It's just like incredible. The little ones. You could use this in class. It's
here
just
we
like
go.
Incredible.
One, two, three.
Oh, that's the Gavon's music. Patricia Cunningham, Christiansen.
Hey,
oh my goodness.
That.
I got to show this to my grandson. He'll love it. Yes, he will. Michael Barberi, Joseph Brennan. That's your handsome husband. Jacqueline Marie, that's Dr. Jackie, your daughter.
Back.
Oh, Carol Portis, that's your
sister.
Hi, Carol, how are you? So many, Patricia, so many nice people. Colleen Powers, I think Colleen Powers is from Somerville as well. And Jerry Mastrolia, who was here earlier.
Jerry was just here.
Hi, Jerry. So we have so many wonderful people that are watching our show. Now, of course, we have come to the section of our show called...
Go ahead!
Keep eating! Now, if you watch the show, if you've never watched the show, I usually around 9:40-ish, I always do...
Time to eat! Yes, it's always time to eat!
We do whatever the section of our show. I try to stay creative and cook every week. However, this week was so crazy, and Lynn said, don't worry, I'm going to bring food from Long Island.
All the way from Long Island.
So look what she brought.
Now, we got a nice eggplant.
Eggplant parmesan. Could you die?
We need it.
Eggplant parmesan. I cannot wait to eat this. And then she brought me... Now, she is kind of a vegetarian, but she brought me a delicious...
A nice little antipasto.
Antipasto salad. Look at that. Right up my alley.
Nice peppers in there. It smells good.
It smells delicious.
It does smell good.
And peppercini in there. Now, you know me. You know I like a good salad.
Avocado.
So what's in here? We have... like mixed greens underneath there. We have avocado, baby grape tomatoes. We have red peppers, my favorite, and baby cucumbers. I'm just squeezed
it
a lemon.
It smells so good here, guys. I wish you could smell right through the tea.
Put some onion salt on there, simple lemon, and then I'm going to throw some extra virgin, garlic olive oil. Yeah,
that's a lot of olive.
And we're going to, yeah, we love garlic. Italians love garlic. And, of course, for... chocolate pretzels.
Well, the kids. I was thinking of Ella and Sienna, the beautiful girls. If they were here, they would like those pretzels.
Yeah, so kids love little chocolate pretzels, so we're going to have that tonight. So that is our kind of like, you know, nice little package from Long Island, right? Well, that's good Long Island food, a little bit of home. That's where Lynn lives. Oh, my goodness, Michael Vaccaro has joined us. But there's two Michael Vaccaros that joined us. This Michael Vaccaro is from Massachusetts. And then we have Michael Vaccaro from L.A. This one is, I believe, is Michael Vaccaro from Massachusetts. And Erin Willis says, yum, yes, delicious.
Erin, she's my student. I love my
girlfriend. Oh, she is?
Awesome, another Taurus. We're talking about Taurus people tonight.
Taurus came up tonight. We're talking about Darius is a Taurus.
My mom.
Your mom, Scott Ryan.
John, my son.
Your son, John. Hey, can we talk about John?
With this jet surf stuff?
So, tell us, what jet surf.
It's like a jet ski, but it's a surfboard. It's crazy.
So, John
but
is
he
the
found
number...
his thing. He's the one in the country.
Number one in the country.
He won for USA. But it's not like it's a big sport.
Well, it's big enough.
I mean,
enough
it's getting bigger and bigger and bigger.
He made the cover of the magazine.
He made the cover of the big... Yeah, his picture is on the cover for the...
So, big shout out.
I have to find the picture, but I'll put it up.
You'll find it. So we speak shout out to John Giuliano.
We're proud of him.
And very jet proud.
Ski. So it looks like a surfboard, but it's got a motor. So it goes like a jet ski. How fast do you think that thing goes? It's like a jet ski, fast.
Wow.
But to
and
get,
he said, talk about balance. So we're bringing
balance.
It back to the
back
balance.
To balance.
But, yeah, it's all about balance. So if you play sports, if you are a dancer, if you just walk, which all of us do in New York. And, you know, you want to, I mean, how many times a day do
Cell
I find
phone,
myself?
People holding the phone, falling.
It's all about your core. And you want to, you know, these are great things that you can do and work on. Dancers.
Robert,
and,
if you're listening, Terry, his friend Terry Ann, if you're out there, her husband was working on how the same thing, on this whole thing on balance and not falling. And it's becoming, it'll save you. It'll save you a broken hip or hello or a broken
any age, you can hurt yourself.
Shoulders, all of them.
And
all of
my dad is starting physical therapy this week again because he had some health issues over the last year, and that's what's it's affected his balance. Mm. Plus ears too, like ears are a
your
big
inner
part.
Ear. Your oh my inner god, ear. People that have that vertigo.
I had it a couple years ago.
It's a nightmare.
Ago.
It's and a, the ringing.
Yeah, all that.
Tinnitus,
stuff.
Tinnitus.
Yeah,
I really don't know the correct.
I think
somebody out there can say.
I think
some people
both
say
correct.
Tinnitus, but I think it's tinnitus. I don't know.
I think it's. I don't. We could ask Dr. Jackie.
She'd say, don't ask me.
She'd say, don't ask me. Now, I know we've told you before, but Lynn does many, many things. So Lynn scores movies. She scores videos. She writes songs constantly. But she also, what she's been doing the last few years that's amazing is she's been writing these Amusie apps.
Yeah, they're Amusie songs, yeah. On
they're
the
little
app.
Quick songs. So E-M-U-S-I app, Amusie app.
Yeah.
If you download that on your phone, that's only $1, right?
Yeah.
And you get how many songs?
It's a free download. If you download the whole thing,
forget
it's
the 1200 for the dollar. You can, come on, you get a buck. freak. Jeez. It's $1.
A buck for this.
A buck for the song.
Everybody wants everything free. It's got to be free. Right, millennials? Free.
Free. So anyway, if you want, there are little clips that you can send in a text. Or put them on Facebook.
Yeah, no more Facebook. They changed that.
Okay. But you can send them on a text.
But it's still going, and people are still using it.
Yeah.
And knock on whatever.
So we'll post that as well. We'll post the Amuse app. I also, Leo will be upset with me if I don't talk about this.
Look,
I'll talk about my merchandise. So,
merchandise.
Yes. What's the story with Maria? Now has merchandise. How can you get this merchandise? Just reach out to me. We will post. You go to the What's the Story with Maria Facebook page, and you can order it. There is a look at that. Go ahead.
Look at her.
Keep eating. This is actually beautiful. We went with blue. Blue is my favorite color this year. So there you go. We have this apron. This is $25. This is the expensive item, but it just costs. These things cost money to make. So, but then for $10, look at this. The little tote bag is now
in New York. Aw, that pretty.
They're getting rid. And look, go ahead, keep eating. You go to the grocery store, you fill that up with your little groceries. $10 for that, because now they're getting rid of plastic bags.
One no more plastic bags.
No, and then, of course, the
There's
cup.
A cup. Coffee.
Look at this, $10. What can you get for $10?
Beautiful.
Not much.
That's beautiful.
Okay, so you got that, and on the back, go ahead, keep eating. I'm telling you. So if you want any merchandise, please reach out to me. You can order through the What's the Story with Marie. You fill out the actual order form, or you can just email me.
Yes.
You can email me at whatsthestorywithmaria@gmail.com, or you can just email me here on Facebook. Facebook message me, and we will get those out to you.
All right.
Yeah. So what else are you working on now? You got a lot.
I'm working. I have a little baby granddaughter. Who is going to be a year old?
Leona Faye. Adorable. That's Nicole's baby. Nicole and Richie.
She's a tough little cookie.
But talk about balance even with a little kid like that. Like she's already walking. She's not.
Yeah, and she does this really cool thing, Erica, with her back. I noticed because now I'm like balance crazy.
Yeah.
But, you know, to watch. She just started walking like 2 months ago, a month and a half ago. She kind of walks. Well, she walks too early. She's not even a year. She walks.
That's amazing.
But she does this really cool arch thing. When she's from a sitting position, she gets up straight. I got to stand. And then she does this complete arch on the back. But she stays. And then I watch her body go whoop, and she goes straight again. It's really cool.
Wow.
Really cool. I'm sure you have a medical term.
Well, no, it's amazing that
but whatever she's doing,
herself.
But it's pretty cool to watch it. And yeah, it's.
Well, if you watch gymnasts when they land.
Yes, that's right. That's what she looks like, a gymnast.
Yeah.
That's what.
I mean, that is how they do
it. How they arch the back. Anyway, look, all of us, just don't fall. My mother used to say the last thing, right, Robert, if you're listening to Carol?
Yeah.
She used to say to her sister Marie, who was older than her, you want to live?
Don't fall.
It's true, though. And Carol, my sister's a nurse. She was like, you know, for the seniors, and she was a visiting nurse for many years. She used to say, it's once they fall.
Yeah.
Once the first fall, then everything else is done. I'm like, oh, God.
Yeah.
I don't want to fall.
Yeah, so you just want to really work on your
balance.
Well,
it's not that. You just, we got to, like Erica says, no, we're not going to fall.
We're not going to fall.
We're going to
work on balance. And core. And also, once you start working on stuff like that, you really want to take care of yourself. You know,
core.
If you missed anybody,
Jackie
Mandar,
Chick Madden,
Mandar, Chick Madden.
He's like here. Hi, Mandar.
Oh my God, sorry, I'm late.
Mandar,
hi, Mandar. You're gonna love this. You got to go back and watch this episode. I think you really enjoy it. But Mandar, we appreciate you. And you know, coming soon, the Maria recipe book, says Mandar.
Oh my God,
Mandar writes all my recipes. I cannot take credit, Mandar.
I like the salad, Mandar. Write that down. That was really nice.
This salad, but I didn't cook anything else.
Avocado.
Lynn brought it. Avocado, mixed greens, baby grape tomatoes, baby cucumbers, and red peppers. You know, I love my red peppers. Squeeze the lemon. That's it. You need a lemon and some olive oil, garlic olive oil, though.
It smells heavenly.
Yeah, we love salads.
It smells
so. But Mandar, so nice to see you, Mandar Chick Magnet.
And Chris DePiro, I want to give another shout out to Chris. I don't know if he's still there, but
please,
Gavone's Produce coming back.
Series
season two. We're coming back. I'm very excited.
Oh my God! Thank God I thought of this. Speaking of Chris DePiro, Chris DePiro made two films for Me and Susie. So he was the filmmaker. He was the filmmaker on both of our movies. The first one is called Keep Eating. Just Eat With Me.
Oh, sorry.
Thank you. That's all right, because this is Keep Eating. Just Eat With Me. You see, everything in my life revolves around food. Just Eat With Me. And the second movie we made is called The No Matter What Club.
Yes, No Matter What
Club. So what we're doing, Susie and I and Chris DePiro, we rented out the Triad on 72nd Street Broadway and I think Columbus, closer to Broadway, Sunday, February 23rd. It's at 8 p.m.
Sunday night. We rented it out.
It's a double feature, but one movie's 22 minutes, the next movie's 40 minutes, so it's really like an hour that you'll be there, but they have a
you will die laughing. It's funny.
You saw the second one.
I saw the second one.
So please come and join us. We're going to have to charge a little bit of a minimum. I mean, a little bit of a cover charge just to cover it. And then there's two drinks. You know, you can get your drinks there. I'm going to go to Costco and get us... I'm telling you, popcorn and all kinds of that.
It's going to be great.
It's going to be so fun. So Sunday, February 23rd at 8 o'clock at the Triad. Please come. It's our double feature.
That sounds fun.
And now, what was
Missing the Person is coming again. Susan and I are doing two shows out on Long Island. If anybody's out there from Long Island that want to see the show, it's Monday the 27th of January.
Wow, that's coming
Monday
up.
Monday night, yeah. 2 weeks. And February 5th, the Wednesday night, also in Merrick and Belmore. It's on my page.
And what is the name of the place?
Missing Person.
The name of the venue.
Guy Anthony's on the Wednesday and Villa Di Acqua in Belmore.
Wow.
Restaurant. Yes.
Wait, good food.
Yes.
That is a great place.
The food's very good. So the show's upstairs and downstairs is dinner.
Yeah, so there's a lot going on. Like,
yeah,
for us as musicians,
winter doesn't mean anything.
Winter, we don't take breaks.
And people say everybody's away, everybody's in Florida. No, a lot of people are still up here.
Yeah, and they're looking for stuff to do. And also, what's great about the winter is that people don't want to be outdoors. They want to be indoors, so they want to see
nice clubs and there's nice shows around.
Angel Gonzalez has joined us. Jim Collier, Long Island, in the house.
Jim, you got to come to Missing Person.
Oh, my God.
It's not, and he's out in a, he's out a little further, but Merrick Road.
Did you play his wedding?
I played Jim's wedding. It was the most beautiful, no diggity. That was
That's right, and Shanna Sharp. Right, so lots going on, and I also, let me see, how much time do we have, Jimmy, about 4 minutes? I think
four and a half.
Thank you, sweetheart. So that's Jim Bell. He's our producer and engineer. He's in New Hampshire. We want to say hi to him.
We have a house in New Hampshire.
Hi, everybody.
Hi, Jim.
We so appreciate Jim. So also, I want to tell you about a new place that I'm working on Saturdays. It's an amazing piano bar. It's in New Jersey. It's right in Jersey City. It's called Pianist. Envy. And it's on 100 York Street between Green and Washington. So... and the music usually starts around 8-ish, 7:30 or 8-ish, and goes to like 12 midnight, a little bit longer. But we're open till 2. So please come out and see us. It's a whole singing staff. Michael Mackesy is the piano player there. I'm there on Saturdays. But they have music every night. But so if you're in the Jersey City area, that's a really fun thing to do too. Right? Okay, so we got about 3 minutes.
We should sing them out.
What should we sing, Lenny? Okay, we love this as our go-to.
The night we met, I knew I needed you so. And if I had the chance, I'd never let you go. So won't you say you love me? I make you so proud of me. We'll make them turn their heads. Every place we go, so won't you what? You for you.
Sing it, Tennessee, so won't you?
What?
Next Tuesday, 9 p.m.
Eastern. Who's coming next week? Anything to report?
Next week, oh my goodness, I do have some. I can't think right now. How much time, Jimmy?
You got a minute.
A minute. Okay, we want to thank Jim Bell of Armed Radio.
Thank you, Jim.
Jim's amazing. He's our producer and engineer.
Thank you, Erica.
We want to thank Erica to March. She is the writer of How Do You Balance Like That? It's a beautiful book. Please go to Amazon right now and order it. And don't forget to order, just for a dollar more, you get our little song that Lynn wrote and I did the voiceovers on. Please remember to do that. Come back and see us every week. Thanks to Joe Rocks from Armed Radio. Thank you. We love and appreciate you. Leo Rodriguez, we miss you already. Good night, everybody.